This recording is protected by copyright. No part may be reproduced without the prior permission of the University of South Australia.
Okay, so I'm going to be talking to you about early childhood education. I wanted to welcome you today because I think that already you've demonstrated two of the qualities that an early childhood educator needs. You've demonstrated persistence and perseverance in even getting here on this very wet and windy day. So, the McEacher Report, Engaging Families in the Early Childhood Development Story, which was published in 2010 and written by someone from South Australia, concluded that the first 5 years of a child's life matter and that those 5 years have a lasting lifetime impact on children. We know that the neuroscience provides compelling evidence that early experiences impact on brain development and that they can have a long-term effect on well-being, so on physical and mental health, on learning and behavior. And so while, of course, parenting is the primary influence on children's development, as early childhood educators, we play an important role. A large proportion of human brain development takes place after birth as a result of interactions with the environment. And by the time a child is 3 years old, 90% of their brain has been developed. We also know that many children these days start in childcare from 6 to 12 months. And so the quality of the relationships and the environment, the learning environment that is provided for those children is critically important. As an early childhood educator, you'll work with children from birth to 8 years of age in a range of settings, in childcare centers, in kindergartens, and in the junior primary classes. Early childhood educators play a pivotal role in the development and education of young children. And so as an early childhood educator, you will learn how to design and teach programs that focus on building high-quality relationships with children. We spend a lot of time talking with our students about how to build attachment relationships with very young children, because we know that without that, those feelings of trust and security, that young children's learning is they're disadvantaged in terms of their learning. And also, you'll learn how to provide environments which interest and engage those children. So if you're interested in helping to set children up for success, then probably early childhood education is the field for you. Why study at early childhood at UniSA? I'm from Canada, so I came to Australia in the 1970s, and one of the things that always has impressed me about South Australia is the very long and respected history in teacher education that South Australia has, over 100 years. So back in 1906, Lillian DeLissa was a young a woman from Sydney. She came to Adelaide and she opened up the first kindergarten on Franklin Street at the age of 21. The kindergartens were so successful and in such demand that a year later, at the age of 22, she set up the first kindergarten teachers' college. So that's quite a remarkable achievement. And throughout the time since, there have been many really outstanding women and men working in the field of early childhood. And one of the buildings, or the building that most of the education staff work in at McGill, is called the Lillian DeLissa Building in recognition of the contribution that she made. We have highly experienced and recognized staff. The staff teach, they do research in the field of early childhood education, in curriculum in the early years, and they do a lot of engagement with community projects as well. It is as a nationally recognized degree, so as for those of you who are in the previous session, as Faye said, if you get teacher registration within South Australia, then you can take that interstate. And it is recognized in many places overseas. One of the strong parts of our program, we believe, is the fact that you do have field placements right from the very beginning. So if you're an early childhood student, you go out into a school in the first study period or semester, and in your second study period or semester, you go into a child care center and work with children from birth to 3 years of age. It says up there on the slide that you have the option to study some courses externally, but the good news is that from next year, our courses will be available fully online, starting with first year and then each year adding a year. And the courses will be available from the regional centers at Mount Gambier and at Whyalla. The undergraduate degree, the Bachelor of Education Early Childhood, is 4 years full-time or part-time equivalent. It does happen at the McGill campus, and as we said, our graduates are eligible for registration here and interstate. We also offer the Master of Teaching, which is a 2-year full-time or part-time equivalent. So you can do a previous degree and then decide, okay, early childhood's for me, and do the a Master of Teaching. Again, that's on McGill, at the McGill campus, and the graduates are eligible for registration both here in South Australia and interstate. So what will you study if you come to do early childhood? We have a strong focus on child development. We believe that teachers of young children need to know about children's development and learning. So you will study courses on development from birth to 3 years across the developmental domains. We have a course that focuses on social and emotional development because we know, as I said earlier, that well-being is fundamental to children's learning. We have courses on cognitive development, the theories of development, and we look at, you know, how our views of children have changed over time and what factors have influenced that. In terms of programming and curriculum, we have courses in literacy and numeracy for the early years, maths and English, phys ed, science, design and technology, humanities and social sciences. And because the arts are such an important part of early childhood, we offer 2 arts courses, whereas most primary students do the 1 arts education. We also offer a course in arts in early childhood. Students learn about research, the theories about how to do research, and strategies and techniques for doing research. So every teacher these days is often involved in some kind of inquiry-based project, so teachers need to have those research skills. They do courses in which teach them how to observe, how to evaluate, and how to assess. And so again, that having that knowledge of child development, of how to evaluate children's learning is really crucial in those early years. We have a big focus on communication and building relationships, and certainly in every professional experience course, you know, there's information given, and students talk a lot about that in the tutorials on campus, where, you know, about building relationships with families, with other staff members, and with the children. And the professional experience placements, which I'll In our program, we have professional experience placements, as I said, the first year in schools. Students go out in a group, and they just get a feel for what does it mean to be a teacher. They have an opportunity to see teachers at work in schools. I worked with some of those students this year, and they came back. They were just so full of excitement. And I think a good understanding of what it did mean to be a teacher. You know, they talked about how organized teachers had to be, how much planning they had to do, how much work they did outside of just the face-to-face teaching that they were engaged in. So it really gave those students in their very first semester at university an understanding of what it does mean to be a teacher. Then our students move on to a childcare placement where they work with children, as I said, either in an infant room or in a toddler room. And they get a sense of, okay, well, what is this early learning like? What do I need to know about children at this age, and how do I work with them? And of course, in a childcare center, because it's teamwork, you know, they have to build their team skills. They have to be independent learners, but they also have to develop those skills to work as a member of a team. Then they go on to do another placement in a junior primary classroom in second year. In third year, they do a placement in a preschool. And then in their fourth year, the students are able to make a choice. Do they want to do a second placement in a preschool setting because they see that that might be where they particularly want to work? Or do they want to do another placement in a junior primary classroom? I think it is important to understand that, you know, if you're doing a full-time program at the university, you've probably got between 12 to 18 hours a week on campus, plus you need then additional time to undertake projects and assignments. So we would say for every 4.5 unit course that you do in a study period, and the full-time load is four courses, you're looking at probably between 8 to 10 hours of work. That's what we were expecting from you. So really, if you're studying full-time, you're doing almost the equivalent of a full-time job. And I think that if you are considering, particularly if you're considering online study, you need to keep that in mind. Because, you know, to study online, I think you have to be well organized. You have to be able to set that time aside to do your study. And I think that's a really important element to consider if that's what you're thinking about doing. Career outcomes are graduates work in childcare centers and children's centers. They often start off as team leaders and graduate to becoming the directors of centers or the pedagogical leader within that center. In kindergartens and preschools, again, they start off as a staff member, but often it's not very long before they take on that leadership role of the director. They can work in junior primary schools and settings. And in associated early childhood services. So we've had students go out and work with local councils on programs that related to young children. They go on to do, you know, with some experience, they can go on to be curriculum writers. They can go on to work in organizations that advocate for young children. So there's a range of potential opportunities there. They're qualified to work within the government schools, the Department of Education and Child Development, within the Catholic Education Department, and in independent schools. And our students do also have that opportunity to get some international exchange experience. I know in the last couple of years we've had students go to America and do a semester study there, and a number of students have gone to my favorite place, back to Canada, to study in Toronto, and really enjoyed that experience. I think it gives you, you know, it takes you outside of your sort of comfort zone and involves you in seeing the world from a different perspective, and that's always a great thing to do. So I'm just going to show you this little video clip. This is Rachel Rodden, who is one of our graduates, and she's just going to talk a little bit about the program from her perspective. Oops.
My name is Rachel Rodham and I studied the Bachelor of Education Early Childhood at the University of South Australia. Teaching is something I've wanted to do from a very early age. When I was in high school, I undertook placements at kindergartens and preschools and found it extremely rewarding working with young children. Each child has their own special way of learning, and understanding this and catering for their individual needs is something that really motivates me. I was attracted to the Bachelor of Education Early Childhood as it allowed me to study and teach from birth to year two, and it also had a variety of field placement opportunities. It's important that children get the best start to their education, as I guess this is a foundation to their future years, and that's what I'm most passionate about. I'm currently working as a Year 1 teacher at Trinity College, and I teach in the curriculum areas of English, Mathematics, Integrated Studies and the Arts, and I found the skills and also the practical experience I undertook during my degree were instrumental in me gaining employment at the end of my degree. The quality of lectures and tutors at the university were exceptional. They were very hands-on. Many of them were past and current teachers themselves, so they had a wealth of knowledge to pass on to us. The degree has a large component of field placements, and this was fantastic because it allowed me to build networks within schools and the community, which ultimately led me to finding work at the end of my degree.
Just in terms of employment opportunities, the federal government has had a really big push to upgrade the quality of education and care for young for very young children. And so one of the new initiatives has been that every childcare centre with more than 25 children in it has to employ an early childhood teacher. So that's going to be a growing area of employment. And that's where I spent my first years when I came to Australia, and I really enjoyed working in a childcare centre because you had that mix of, you know, you were working with families, you were working with the children, and I really enjoyed that aspect of my work. What does it take to be an early childhood teacher? I think you do have to have patience. You need to be flexible. I think flexibility is even more important when you're working with very young children. You need to enjoy working not just with the children, but also with their families, because with those very young children, you know, families are still a very important part of their lives. You need to have excellent communication, interpersonal and organizational skills. A sense of warmth and a sense of humor always helps. One of the things that I really enjoy about working with young children is their honesty. You know, they tell you what they think, they tell you, and so you learn quite a lot about yourself because they just tell it like it is. They haven't yet learnt all of those social skills we have as we get older for masking what it is we think. You do have to have an interest in learning and in lifelong learning. I've been learning ever since I started my first degree many years ago, and I'm still learning. I think, too, that one of the other key things about working in early childhood is that you do have to be, you know, able to work independently, but you also have to have those skills to work as a team member. Certainly in childcare centres and preschools, you're working with a team of other people. And so the skills to manage that, you know, to negotiate the conflicts that sometimes arise when you're working as a team member. Those are important skills for students to learn. I think you also need to have empathy. You need to have that ability to put yourself in another person's shoes because, as I said, particularly when you're working with young children, you're also working with their families, and sometimes the families come and you think, oh, I don't agree with that. But often, if you listen to what the families have to say, you get a different perspective on that, and you come to respect that, and you find a way to work with those parents that's respectful of them, but also respectful of your own beliefs. And of course, the ability to problem solve. You know, that's really what young children's education is about. They're problem solvers. Everything that they come across is something that they are busy learning, you know, to solve that problem. And I often say to students who go, I've got students going out on a childcare prac at the moment, and they come back and they say, but I tried to read the book to the baby, but, you know, all she wanted to do was chew it or to throw it away or flip through all the pages. And I say, yeah, because you know what a book is. You've been doing things with a book for a long time. But for babies, it's just an object, and they're learning about it. And so that's what babies do. They put books into their mouths. So it is about learning, you know, to see the world from the perspective of the child and from the perspective of the families. The entry pathway here to our program last year was 73.3 with a preferred entry of 80. There's a range of ways. We have a lot of students, and Rebecca will talk about this pathway. We have a lot of students who do their diploma of children's services, work for a while, and then apply to do the Bachelor of Early Childhood Education. Those students, when they come into the program, are granted credit for 6 of our courses. So it's, you know, they come in with a body of knowledge, and we recognize that and give them credit for that. So On that note, I'd like to introduce Rebecca to tell you a bit about what it's like to be a student in our program.
Hi, it's great to see so many people here and welcome. I guess just picking up on Christy's point, my entry into university wasn't straight from school. I finished school not knowing what I wanted to do, and you might find that some of you are in that pathway as well. So I worked for 6 months and then I got accepted into a Diploma of Community Services at TAFE, which is focuses on childcare. So I did that, that was 2 years, and then I went and worked in the childcare industry for 14 years before I finally decided that I would actually come back to university and do my degree. That being said, it wasn't too difficult. There are multiple pathways to getting to university, so if you don't get in on your ATAR score alone, there are certainly other pathways. So I applied with my knowledge from my diploma, and also the years of experience that I had, and got accepted as an adult student in university. I've got to say it's been a very supportive environment, not just for adult students, but also for students that come straight from school. It is an academic undergraduate degree, so be prepared that you do have to do the hard work, the hard yards, but studying early childhood is just amazing. It's fantastic. I love teaching. You'll find again that everything in early childhood, especially in your birth to five bracket, is very relationship based. And so the university takes a special interest in teaching people how to work in the dynamics of those relationships as well. So you'll find that when you study at UniSA in early childhood, you will do a lot of group work with people. So there'll be group presentations and speeches you'll have to do. You'll have to do PowerPoints. So these are forms of technology that you need to be familiar with. Again, there's the e-portfolio, which is relatively new, and you'll need to learn how to use that when you become a student as well. Myself and a couple of my classmates have just done a project on e-portfolio, so it was a very, very interesting piece of technology to use. I think also it's a very rewarding career. It's a career that's flexible, so you can find that if you need to stop teaching for a particular reason, it's something that you can come back to so long as you maintain your teacher's registration. That's really important, and again, that differs from state to state and territory as well. But I understand that they're looking at maybe unifying that process at some point too. Again, yet very rewarding. I think one of the things I've noticed most about university coming in, especially in the first year I was there, was how students learn to interact with their lecturers and their tutors. Some people find that more daunting than others. For me, it wasn't too much of an issue. I came in already as an adult, but I do find that some students that come straight from Year 12 are so used to that relationship of Year 12 student to teacher, that relationship actually changes. You're expected to contribute a lot more in class, give your opinion. It's okay to have an opinion, and it's okay to have a difference of opinion, as long as you differ respectfully. But that's probably a really important point to note. Myself, I got credit for my first year, again, coming in with the diploma. So I've only had to do 3 years. I'm doing honours this year. So I'm doing a thesis at the moment on children's documentation, which is really very interesting. But for me, doing this, it also opens up career pathways towards doing a PhD as well. So that's something that I'm considering at the moment too. For those of you that aren't familiar with university terminology, I've found this to be a helpful point for some people, is that when you study at school, you call it a semester, we call it a study period, and also your subjects, we call them courses as well. So I found some people do get a little bit confused on those points. Other than that, that's probably all I've got to say.
Thank you very much, Rebecca. Okay, so if you'd like to find out more about the Early Childhood Program, we do have McGill at Twilight on Wednesday the 18th of September. It's a chance to come up and see what we believe is the best campus at UniSA. And there will be more study and career information. I think there's tours. If you're from the country, they take They take you around and show you where accommodation possibilities. There's a short film festival and there's food and music, so it's usually a really good evening. And if you would like more information, you can always contact the Future Student Inquiries. So if